Hello, I am Flash Isaac. This is Flash Nenas. You are now watching 120 Days to Jam. This is a series containing 120 videos to prepare you for Jam. Each episode of the series contains introduction, outline, detailed class, questions, and homework for you. The questions and homework are from the Flash Learners Jam application. Install Flash Learners Jam app today to access all the free features. Click activate and scroll to buy activation key to get access to the golden features. Don't be scared, the app is affordable. Do you have trust issues? Simply chat me directly on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, and Telegram for installation and activation instruction. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to take off. Hi, this is episode 4 of the 120 Days to Jam Chemistry with Flash Isaac. The first thing Jam expects you to know in chemistry is separation of mixtures and purification of chemical substances. So far, we've done a lot under separation of mixtures and purification of chemical substances. Under separation processes or separation techniques, Jam expects you to understand the principle of evaporation, filtration, distillation, magnetization, precipitation, sieving, separating funnel, crystallization, decantation, and chromatography. Now, this class will focus on evaporation, filtration, distillation. We have simple and fractional distillation, magnetization, and precipitation. Episode 5 will complete the separation technique. The first technique here is evaporation. That is what Jam expects you to know. Evaporation operates on the principle of volatility difference. When there is difference in volatility, then we employ evaporation. What is volatility? It is simply the property of a substance to escape or evaporate or disappear when heated. Evaporation is used to separate solutes from solution if the solute does not decompose on heating. If this is a bowl of water, you pour salt inside. Now, since the salt dissolves in water, the water is the solvent. The salt is the solute. When you mix them together, they form solution. To separate this solute from solution, you use evaporation. But on one condition, the solute should not be the type that decomposes on heating. Because some solutes, when you heat, they break down, they decompose. As such, you cannot separate them. So, evaporation is used to separate solute from solution if the solute is not the type that decomposes on heating. Or you can say, to separate soluble solid from liquid if the solid does not decompose on heating. Examples are salt making from sea water. Salt dissolves in water, but salt does not decompose on heating. Water is volatile. Salt isn't volatile. When you heat, because water is volatile, water evaporates, escapes, leaving behind salt in the bowl. Therefore, you separate it. If you wish to get the water back, after the evaporation, you can condense it somewhere to trap the water so that it cools down, it condenses and turns back to liquid. That is if you need the water. Another example is solution of copper sulfate. Copper sulfate is a salt dissolved in water but does not decompose on heating. So you can separate that using evaporation. The next is filtration. Filtration should not be something new to you. It is simply to filter. You have water at home, they say, there is dirt here. Remove this dirt, remove this particle. You are filtering. That is why
Filtration operates on the principle of difference in particle size. Filtration operates on the principle of difference in particle size. Wow, I need to up my English game. Now, it is used to separate solids from liquids or gases using filter. Filtration is something we are familiar with. For example, when you are purifying water, you see the particles, difference in particles, you put filters on here, you pour water in it, you notice that the larger particles, they will be at the filter while the pure water goes down. In your generator, if you are the tank that goes to turn fuel in the gen, you notice something. At the tank, you see something, filter, you are turning fuel, that filter is removing particles that are bigger than the fuel, so that it doesn't kill your gen, or so that it doesn't block the carburetor, so that bad fuel doesn't enter the carburetor and your carburetor begins to develop fault. Then if you are the type, you are someone that comes to service your air conditioner, or you are used to air conditioner repair and maintenance, you notice that in every AC, we have filter. After a while, when you remove the filter, you see dust, particles, sand, rubbish inside the filter. It gets so dirty that may affect the cooling of your AC. In some cases, if your AC doesn't cool very well, it is the filter. Remove the filter, wash it, and put back, then your AC will be cooling. But in a case where your AC is blowing only breeze, there is no cool at all. Not that it's not cooling, but it's not cooling at all. It's just breeze, only breeze or fan. Then that is not filter. That may be gas, to a large extent, gas, or your compressor is not picking up. Now, simple distillation. In distillation, we have simple and fractional distillation. They both operate on the principle of difference in boiling point. When you have difference in boiling point between mixtures, you employ distillation. However, there is a dichotomy, discrepancy, disparity between simple and fractional distillation. When you have two miscible liquids with far apart boiling points, you employ simple distillation. When you have two or more liquids with very close boiling points, you use fractional distillation. Now a question comes to mind: which boiling point is too close and which boiling point is too far apart? For boiling points, for two or more miscible liquids with boiling points lesser than 25 Kelvin, you use fractional distillation. If the difference in boiling point is bigger than 25 Kelvin, then it is a wide boiling point. You use simple distillation. To separate acetone from water, acetone is 56 degrees Celsius, water is 100 degrees Celsius. They are far apart. You employ simple distillation. Making of local gin, alcohol, the mixtures, the two mixtures or the two liquids, they are far apart boiling point. So you employ simple distillation. That is what is used in making of alcohol. Kind. Then for fractional distillation, methanol and ethanol or petroleum fraction. The petroleum fraction, they have very close boiling point range. So we employ fractional distillation to remove each of the components. For example, the fractions of petrol are petroleum gas. As you are boiling or you are heating, petroleum gas at a temperature of less than 20 degrees Celsius, it escapes off, it has boiled. Other components will not boil yet. It goes off, you collect it. At around 20 degrees to 160 degrees Celsius, petroleum ether, which is another component. Then around 60 to 100 degrees Celsius, lignin goes off. Then petrol, kerosene, diesel oil, lubricating oil, asphalt, and bitumen. These are petroleum fraction. And magnetization is a separation technique that operates based on principle of magnetizability. It is used to separate magnetic solid from non-magnetic solids. Example, iron filings and sand mixture. The iron filings, when you take magnets to them, they will begin to jump on top of the magnet. But the sand is not magnetizable. So that is the principle. Then precipitation. Take note of this, very important. Precipitation works on difference insolubility. That is the principle. Difference in solubility. Difference in solubility. And it is used to separate soluble solid from two miscible liquids. When you have one solid that can dissolve from two liquids that are miscible, you use precipitation. Then it also involves a process of making one of the liquids insoluble or trying to make the solid insoluble. So you manipulate one of the mixture to make it insoluble so that you can separate it. But know that precipitation is used to operate based on difference in solubility, ability to dissolve in solution, and it is used to separate soluble solid from two miscible liquids. Silver nitrate and sodium chloride aqueous, they can be separated using precipitation. So, we come to the end of this episode. Let's take a look at the questions for us. And don't forget, when you open your Flash Analysis app, click question search, go search mixture. You answer all these questions, 1, 2, 5, 14, and 8. Search separation techniques. Begin to answer questions. The ones to be solved, the ones to be not answered. Because in the next class, we are dealing with the remaining guys. The first question I have here is, the separation technique that is based on the principle of solubility of a solid in two miscible liquid is that. This is like straight to the point. Solubility of solid from two miscible liquids. That is precipitation. It is so clear. Distillation is difference in boiling point. Filtration is difference in particle size. And fractional distillation is difference in boiling point. A mixture is different from compound because this is a question under episode 2. Remember, in this class, you can expect any question at all. The aim is to pass jam. So, mixture is different from compound in that the constituents of a compound are chemically bound together, while those of mixtures are not. Which of these properties gives a solid its definite shape? It is the strong bonding holding them, strong intermolecular bonding. The difference between solid, liquid, and gases is the strength of the bond, the force of attraction between the molecules. In solid, it is highest. In gas, it is the smallest. And this is, a mixture of sugar and sulfur can be separated by dash. Sulfur does not dissolve in water. Sugar dissolves in water. So when you pour water inside them, or you pour them inside water, sugar will dissolve. Sulfur will be there. So when you dissolve in water and filter, sulfur is out, you are left with a mixture of sugar and water. When you evaporate, like we said, sugar will not decompose. As you heat, water will go, sugar will be left behind. You see, this requires wisdom and it is very, very interesting. So get your Flash Analysis app, activate it, and do your homework. See you in the next class.